Some loads, like motors, have starting caps that can demand large currents during startup. This large current may trip protections in the pack, effectively shutting down the system. To solve this dilemma, the BQ40z80 has a way to pre-charge the output, effectively soft-starting the load to make sure the overcurrent protections aren't reached. The pre-charge function is similar in the charge direction, directly driving the pre-charge PFET. However, the pre-discharge is only able to drive an NFET, which in turn drives the PFET for pre-discharge. The pre-discharge level is set to determine when the pre-discharge FET turns off and is in terms of a percent of the top of the cell stack or bat voltage. When the pre-discharge level is reached, or the pre-discharge timeout is reached, the pre-discharge FET turns off and the discharge FET turns on. The pre-discharge current is adjustable through the resistor from the pre-discharge PFET to pack. The BQ40z80 EVM is configured where the charge and discharge FETs are in series. This means that when charging, current flows through both FETs, and when discharging, current flows through both FETs. The gauge implements protection for the charge FET so that in series configuration, if the charge FET is off and the discharge FET is on, and if the discharge current is greater than the charge current threshold, the charge FET is turned on quickly to protect the charge FET body diode from discharge current flowing through it. This is the proper operation for FETs configured in series, but what about parallel configuration? In many high cell applications, the discharge current may be an order of magnitude greater than the charge current. For example, it is not uncommon for cordless vacuum cleaners to approach 20 amp discharge currents, yet only charge at 2 amps or less. In this case, if the discharge and charge FETs are in series, they both need to be sized for the highest current to minimize power loss as well as control temperature of the FET. The BQ40z80 includes support for a circuit configuration where the charge and discharge FETs are in parallel rather than in series, allowing for the charge FET to be higher RDS on, smaller packaging, and lower cost. This also saves the power loss through the charge FET during discharge, getting the most out of the battery for the load. In parallel configuration, if the charge FET is off and the discharge FET is on, then the charge FET is not turned on if discharge current is detected, since these paths are completely independent. The BQ40z80 EVM does not support the parallel configuration right now, but a TI design is planned for the future. Finally, what if you need cell balancing for all the cells in your application? The good news is that the BQ40z80 has internal cell balancing for 6 cells, and it supports external cell balancing for the 7th cell. All 7 cells can be set up for external cell balancing if higher balance currents are needed. Refer to Section 8 of the TRM for details on cell balancing, which provides the calculations needed to set the balance time based on the internal or external balancing circuits. Cells 1 through 6 are calculated, and there is a separate calculation for the 7th cell. Thanks for taking time to learn how the BQ40z80 2S through 7S battery pack manager can solve some of the common challenges for high cell count applications. If you have other challenges you need help with, please submit them on e2e.ti.com. Thanks.